Our guest tonight is a legend, somebody that I've been a fan of in many different incarnations in different ways, and I was surprised to find out she had a new record coming out, and we'll talk about that. But right now, let's introduce on the telephone lines our guest, Miss Brie Darling. Hello, Brie.
Hey, how are you doing?
Much better now that you're here.
Aw, thanks. It's nice to be here with you.
Yeah, so where are you calling from?
I am in Los Angeles.
Okay, great. Yeah, Tracy and I have been waiting for this all week.
Oh, great. I have been, too. I'm looking forward to this.
Now, you know, I was surprised when I found out that you and Cherie Kiri had a new project together, and I've been reading online about it, but for those of the folks that are listening tonight that maybe don't know, in a nutshell, how did this project get together with you and the ex-Runaway singer?
Well, you know, I had played with the band Fanny back in the 70s, and she was with the Runaways, and we had not met before, and we were working about the same time with our, you know, pioneering girl band. And then Jean and June Millington for Fanny and I, a couple of years ago, had the opportunity to do another Fanny record. And we did one. It's called Fanny Walk the Earth. And I wanted to have some of the other women from bands, other girl bands that were around, that, you know, that we came up with and that, you know, we followed and that followed us. And I invited some of the girls from the Bangles, the Go-Go's, Alice Bagg, and some of the other girls that were in Fanny that weren't part of the record, and the Runaways. And Cherie came on board. Patty Quatro introduced me to her. And Cherie just, and I hit it off, you know. It's like the minute she walked into the room, she has this charisma that is just undeniable, and she's just got that kind of energy that, you know, she draws you to her. And we were drawn to each other. And one thing I love about Cherie, she is just forthcoming with how she feels about things. And she was great. She told me she loved my voice, which, it, you know, was not a lot of people are, you know, forthcoming with that kind of, you know, that so openly complimentive. So it was awesome to feel that great about having her there. And of course, she did a fantastic job singing on one of the singles that we put out, a song called When We Need Her. And since Cherie lives in Los Angeles, a lot of the girls, you know, came in from out of town, or some of them flew their parts in. And Cherie lives here. So we had her come back on and do some step outs. And so she and I were in the studio together, and I just loved what she did, and I just loved her energy, and we felt the same about each other.
Now,
and
I know.
Go ahead.
Oh, I know. Back in the 70s, when she was getting her moment of fame with the Runaways, were you a fan of the band? Were you a fan of the Runaways?
You know, it's funny because the Runaways came kind of followed Fanny.
Yeah,
right,
they,
after Fanny,
they did.
So,
I was going to say that you. I mean, I don't know, for those people who don't know this, Brie was like, you know, you were one of the first people, you were like 14 years old when you joined the Musicians Union, right? And you became one of the first female rock drummers to even make a record, and you were like 15?
I was. I started playing when I was 14. It was kind of an accident. And then my little band in the town that I lived in, we went into Sacramento, which was the big city, and recorded three songs. So it makes me one of the first, you know, girl drummers to record, you know, rock drummers to record. And I just kind of realized that not that long ago. And so by the time Fanny came about, that, you know, and eventually I met June and Jean in Sacramento, because that's where they're from, the girls that at the time the band was called The Spells, and that turned into Fanny. And that was in, you know, from 1969 to 1974 or 5, by the time the band split up. And the Runaways, I think, were just taking off about 1974.
Right,
so
around
they
that
were
time.
Right at the end of Fanny. Now, I heard them. I went to an SIR rehearsal, and I saw the Runaways. And it's so funny because music was changing, and they were so rough and ready. And it was kind of like shocking to me what they were doing. I remember that at the time.
Wow.
You know, music was changing. They were crunchy and hardcore, and I don't know if I was ready for it. And, you know, and then we started moving, you know, the girls that were in Fanny, we started moving in other directions. Like, I actually got into recording for a lot of other acts and touring. And the Runaways were kind of taking over what was happening in music. So that's like I said, Cherie and I never met. But when we did meet, you know, we found out that our roots were the same. And that's how we ended up working together, is we listened to the same music at the same time, which was the early 70s, you know.
Like
and
Bowie.
Mine was a little bit before that. But we, yes, exactly.
Hey, are you
we
aware?
The same influences.
Are you aware of the famous quote that Bowie said about Fanny?
Oh, yeah. He used to come to our shows.
Okay, because in 1999, Gosh. Bowie said that Fanny was one of the finest rock bands of their time.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes. And, you know, my one regret was that he didn't live to hear the record that we got to do again. That was kind of a little sad, because he said in that same interview, he said, revivify Fanny and my job will be done.
Wow.
And it would have been nice that he could hear that. Yeah, he was great. He used to come to our shows and give us advice. One thing that he said to me, like one time we were playing at a theater, and him and his entourage walked up the aisle while we were playing, and all of the lights went to him, and he sat down, and then the lights came back on us. And he came back and he says, girls, always make an entrance. And, you know, he knows how to do it. And he gave us such great advice, and he was a big fan. And our biggest, Fanny's biggest hit, which was Butterboy, that Jean wrote, was written about David Bowie. And I just found out from her in an interview, probably in the last couple of months, that I don't even know if David ever knew that song was written about him. So.
Aw. Hey, Bree, your phone's kind of cutting out a little bit all of a sudden.
Oh, no, okay. Does that sound any better?
Yeah, it's just like it's really
does
cutting
out. Does it sound
out.
Better now?
Not really.
Uh-oh. I don't know why it's cutting out.
That's strange. Yeah, it was fine until we started talking about Bowie. Then it started getting weirder and weirder. It's like, uh-oh.
You know, I can hear that. I'm going to walk to a different area. And
oh, that's fine. And we're used to this. It's happened before.
We can still tell what you're saying. It's just kind of like, kind of almost like you're underwater a little bit.
Does this sound any better?
Not really.
Oh.
Eek.
What a drag.
Yeah, I don't know. Tracy, what do you think?
I say we keep rolling and maybe if it, see if it gets any better.
I can hear the static.
I wonder if we should try to call back and try to do a reconnection, perhaps. I wonder.
Yeah, why don't we try that? Because I don't want people to not be able to hear this.
Right? Should we try to call back and see if we can get a better connection or no?
Try to call me back, sure. I'm going to move it to a different part of the house and maybe it'll just be a better connection.
Okay, we'll call back. We'll call Ken and do this again real quick.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to give it a shot. It's worth it. Let's try this again, guys.
No, that was weird because I could hear Ken at the end. Like he was crystal.
Well, it's live radio, and it just happens. It's just the way it is. Let's go ahead and try it again. It's worth it, right?
Yeah, and just in the meantime, I just kind of wanted to tell people, you know, what a big deal that Bree really is. I mean, she's kind of being a little modest. She was in the first all-girl band signed to a major record label. Like I said, she was the first drummer to be... you know, in 1964, a professional musician at age 14, and the first female rock drummer to make an album. And she's just a legend. If you get a chance to get some free time, go check out Fanny. They're one of my favorite all-time bands, just like the Runaways are. And Bree is just a legend. So, you know, we want this interview to go perfectly. And if you cannot hear it perfectly, that's not good for us. So... we're going to try to make this work.
Okay, you guys are back on.
Okay, Bree, how's it going?
Okay.
Okay, I got you. You sound great. I'm going to put you right back on.
Okay, great.
Okay, we are being rejoined by Bree Darling, and she is there. Hello, Bree.
Hey there. So sorry about that.
That's okay. Much better. Don't you miss like old school wall phones sometimes?
Yes. I swear to God, it makes the minute we started having a problem, I thought, don't I have a landline somewhere? No, I don't.
No one does. It's crazy.
No.
I want one. So we know that the motivator is supposed to drop August 2nd. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right, and we're really excited about that.
Blue Elan Records. How did you guys get connected with Blue Elan Records? What's the story?
Blue Elan Records is, my husband does a lot of production for Blue Elan Records, and that is the company that actually, when we did the Fanny Walk the Earth record, June, Gina, and I happened to do a show together, and I posted a little 14-second video, and the record company president, Kirk Passage, saw the video and said, basically, in a nutshell, offered us a deal. And so we did that Fanny Walk the Earth record. And then, unfortunately, our bass player, Jean, right when the record was released, she had a stroke. Oh. So we could not go out and support that, and which was a shame. We really wanted to do that. I was looking really forward to playing. So it took me a minute to kind of accept what was going on, and I just kind of went back into creative mode. I went back into the studio and started writing some songs, and I didn't know what they were going to be for. But then Cherie said, hey, do you want to play a show with me? I'm going to go do Cherry Bomb for a St. Jude's Hospital benefit. And I said, I'd love to. So I played drums with her and sang backups with her, and we had so much fun together. I realized what I had been writing for. I played her a couple of things. She loved it, and we came up with the idea since the songs from the late 60s, early 70s was, both of our, the group's songs and artists from that time. It's a very special time in music history where songs are so special that they still to this day, they still speak true, and they still are strong songs that people still love.
Yeah, we noticed, For What It's Worth and Gimme Shelter.
Yes.
Wow.
Right. Yeah, those, they stand the test of time. So we realized that we could make that record, because these are the songs and the artists that influenced who we became as recording artists. So it was kind of a perfect match, and I gotta tell you, we are having so much fun working together
and it shows
creating together. It's like I don't think I've ever worked with anybody where it just flows, where she is strong, where I am not as strong, she takes over and it's awesome. And sometimes, I have ideas where it's just we work so well, we fill the gaps. And it's like magic. And then working with my husband, Dave Darling, who produced our record, the three of us together, I just think it's dynamite.
And Dave Brand,
I don't know if you've heard the whole record.
I have not. We've only heard like maybe four or five cuts off of it.
Okay, well, great. Well, I'm glad you've heard four or five cuts, because I'm really thrilled with the record, and I can't wait. We're starting to work on the second record, so we're pretty excited about that.
And if those that didn't know, Dave Brandt, by the way, is six-time Grammy-nominated producer.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Dave Darling, my husband, he's done some really fine work, and it's an awesome record, yeah.
And Brie, just from being a fangirl over here, I'm actually sweating because we're on the phone with you. I'm a total fan.
I love that. Thank you.
You rock. And just to let you know, from a fan's point of view, when I first heard that you were putting this thing together with Cherie and this was going on, I'm like, wow, I wonder what this is going to be like, and I mean, just you can tell what you just said is true, that you and Cherie mesh perfectly. Like, you guys, it's true that things happen in life when they're supposed to, because you guys met at the right time. It seems like you said, where she leaves off, like you fill in, and where you leave off, she fills in, and you guys look fabulous. I was like looking, I'm like, these ladies look like they're in their 20s, like they're at their prime, and it's so good to hear you doing, and especially like the T-Rex. I'm like a complete T-Rex fanatic, so just, I'm so glad that, you and Shuri found each other and that you're doing this project, because, and I hope you do another, because it's awesome. It really is.
Thank you, Tracy. You know, it's really wonderful for me to hear that from a woman, too, because I think, not to take anything away, Derek, but, you know, I think women really get that and really appreciate that, you know. When you find somebody that you have so much in common with and you can join forces and forge ahead and hold each other up.
Yeah.
And you know, it really is just, and I'm getting goosebumps thinking about it. It's a beautiful thing. And sometimes it's hard to find. Like when we get together, it's just like it's a ball of energy. There's like an electricity going on. That's not necessarily an easy thing to find, even with other women artists, you know, because sometimes, you know, you find somebody that you love to death as a friend or as somebody you work with, but you might have to work to get something out of them. And with me and Sheree, it's like, you know, I'm like dying to speak and bring out my idea, but I'm dying also to hear what she has to say. And it really is a wonderful thing. And I'm so grateful that that we met. And hey, listen. We could have met all these years that we have both been around, living not that far from each other.
Yeah.
We could have gotten together. Now is the right time. I have no regrets about it happening right now, because what we have right now couldn't be if it didn't happen right now.
That's
exactly.
Right.
Everything had to happen the way it did. Listen, both wonderful things and sad things that have happened. It took everything for these stars to line up, and I'm grateful. She and I have our first show just in, like, just a couple of weeks. We're going to be doing the Grammy Museum on August 1st.
So excited for you guys.
Yeah, that's our first show, and we had a little vocal rehearsal here at our studio here at my house just a couple of days ago, and I thought, okay, it's going to be a little rough at first. We sounded so freaking cool. I was going, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I cannot wait.
That's so cool. Will you be doing a full tour after the album's out then?
Yeah, we've got we're with TKO. That's our booking agency. And we're going to be heading out. I don't know exactly when or where, but I just got an email from them the other day. They're going to be at the Grammy Museum, and they've got a plan for us. And so we're going to be heading out, and both she and I are so excited to go out and do this. And, you know, Sheree, the way she tells it, and I don't want to speak for her, but she said it so many times, she was ready to quit the entertainment business. She was just giving up. She was fed up with it. And
it's hard being a woman in that business.
She was reinvigorated, and I just am so grateful that I got her just in time before she was ready. She bought property. She was moving out of L.A., and so she's here now. She's here to stay for a while longer. We've got a 4-record deal, so we plan to be doing this for a little while.
Kick
and, you know,
ass.
Hey,
well, we'll be
excited about it.
We are so going to catch. If I have to, like,
Portland.
Yeah, if I have to walk on nails backwards, naked all the way there, I'm making one of those shows. There's no way.
Oh, yeah, we'll be. Hey, listen, and when we come up there, we definitely want to stop by if you want to see us.
Whoa. Absolutely.
That would be so cool if we could come into the station. Could we do that?
Of course.
Are you kidding
me?
That
would be so cool.
If not, we'll come in. We'll get a hold of you guys one way or another, and we'll make sure we meet you guys somehow.
Yeah, that would be so cool. I love doing that.
I have a fanboy. Speaking of, she said fangirl. I have a fanboy thing. From 1986, you were in a band called American Girls. And you opened up for one of my favorite bands at the time. And I just wanted to briefly mention it to see what you might say about that. And you were opening
Lords of the New Church?
Lords of the New Church with Steve Vaders.
They were so awesome.
Nice.
They were wacky.
Yeah, to say the least.
I wondered what you thought about those. That's all. You know, I just wondered what you thought.
Steve Vader was such an awesome guy. We had so much fun. They were wacky. We were surfing on the top of vans on the road, one behind the other. We were bad. We were crazy. And we're lucky that we're alive. And he was all in, Steve Vader. And it was really an introduction to some super madness, because they were super punk, super crazy, super out there. And But the thing is also Stiv was really, he was also very organized and very well planned. I think I forgot the name of the place that we were playing in New York. He was down on stage. I was up in the balconies watching, and he started climbing the curtain and started climbing the up to the balconies. And he was climbing up to where I was, and he was like telling me he was going to, like, he wanted me to sing one of the songs with him since I had watched the show every night and I knew it. And he just leaned over like he was like had like, I don't know, something, blood or something dripping from his mouth. And he leaned over off my phone. He said, just follow my lead. I said, okay.
Okay.
And then we did this whole thing together, and it was like outrage looking, but he had it planned. I mean, he was climbing that curtain, and he was climbing up to the balcony, and he was taking his life in his own hands. But he was thinking about what he was going to do. So it was definitely an exciting thing to play with Lords of the New Church. Great
nice.
Guys.
Yeah, I just had to ask that because I saw that online. I'm like, I've got to ask, you know. What yeah. people might not know is your first band was a band called The Keynotes in 1964, right?
Right. That was my very first band, my very first working band.
From Stockton. Were you guys in Stockton?
No, I lived in a little town called Folsom, which was when I left there in 1960, I guess, seven.
Yeah.
There was only 5,000 people. It was tiny. And I was, the guitar player was 12 years old. He was a little genius, a wonderful, wonderful guitar player. And I was lucky that I got that job. And the way I got that job is my brother was going to audition to be the drummer in that band. And they showed up to my parents' house. And I happened to be sitting on the drums, and the guitar player's mother was the manager, and she walked in and she saw me sitting on the drums, and she says, "You're it. You're the drummer."
And that's cool.
I didn't even really know how to play very well, but I learned real quick, and that was my introduction to music. And that one moment that I happened to be sitting on those drums,
wow,
changed the rest of my life.
Talk about
and
timing.
I'm grateful for it. And I have wonderful brothers. My younger brother Henry gave me his drum set. My older brother Phil, he was the one that was auditioning for the band. He gave me his job, and they've always been completely supportive.
That's
and wonderful. And
so cool.
Yeah, and that's why I've been able to do what I can do, is because I have a very supportive, always have had a very supportive family. And now they've joined Sheree and I on this record. Both my two brothers and my sister are on this new record.
Wow.
And so it kind of makes it a little digital family heirloom for me. And Cherie's sister is on this record.
Her ex-husband,
Bob Hayes, is on this record too. So it's,
wow.
I love sharing this with Cherie. I've never been able to do this with anybody else before. We're so similar that we have these same things that are important to us. And that's such a great thing too, you know. We're both very family oriented and you know, very business oriented too. But
well, you're like a Renaissance woman. You
partner.
You're like a Renaissance woman. Not only are you, were you in the first, all female rock band in Fanny? I mean, just a kick-ass drummer. A great musician, but you also make fabulous cakes that I don't know if a lot of people know about this, but
award-winning cake designer.
Yeah, award-winning cake designer. Like, some of these cakes are just, yeah. And how
that
did you...
was really fun. You know, that was kind of a little, like, just offshoot thing that I saw, people making cakes on TV, and I thought, I can do that. So I tried it for a while, and it accidentally turned into a little bit of a business, and for a few years, it was just really, really fun for me, and it was a challenge.
Yeah, it's
and
not
I
easy.
I do a lot of different kinds of artwork, so that was just really an artistic adventure for me, and I loved it.
She invented the process of baking leopard print cakes. How cool is that?
That
That's
idea
so awesome.
Just came to me in the middle of I don't know, just one day I thought, wow,
even
how about decorating the inside? And I don't know if I still see anybody doing that. So
even your cakes
wow.
are even your cakes are rock and roll, man.
I hope my sister's listening, because she's kind of like an amateur cake person, and she would really, really be she would be blown away by the whole leopard print cake thing.
I have a question.
It's pretty good. Yes.
This is another fanboy, and it's the last fanboy question.
You
I just,
lie.
That's okay. You can be fanboy all you want. I love it.
Well, this is one that's really close to my heart because I'm a big, big fan of this man who's no longer with us. But I just found out yesterday that you played, and I'm not even sure what you did on it, to be honest, but you performed on the Keith Moon solo album.
Right.
Oh, yes. My God.
I didn't. You didn't
I've got that
me.
On vinyl. I love that record.
What?
Yeah, this was ages and ages ago, and I'm trying to remember exactly how it happened, and I think I've just been reminded fairly recently. When I was in Fanning, Patty Quatro was friends with Roger Daltrey.
From The Who.
Yes. And so Keith Moon was doing his solo record, and somehow we got invited to go down and sing on the record. So
wow.
Patty and I think Gene went down there to, let's see, what studio was that? It was a real famous one. I'm not remembering the name of the studio. It was down on La Cienega and 3rd. And we went down there, and Keith was out of his ever-loving mind, and we sang on his record.
Wow.
And it's so funny. I was so young, and I was so stupid. I was listening to something that he did, and I made some kind of comment, and he said to me,
"Oh, no.
Well, that's really nice. We can do that when it's your record."
Oh.
I think I had the nerve to make a suggestion or something, but
wow.
He was great. He was a character, and yeah, I had the honor of doing that.
Wow, that's a trip. I just had to ask. And if you're just now listening, if you're tuning in, you're listening to an interview with Bree Howard Darling from Fanny, Walk the Earth, from Cherie Carey and the Bree Darling Band. It's a great conversation. You're listening to KSKQ at the Church of Rock. And before we let you go tonight, is there anything we'd like to cover, Bree, that we might not have covered?
I don't know. I just want to say you guys are awesome. This is I've had a great time talking with you guys. I think you're both awesome. Thank you for coming up with some kind of, new questions.
Off the wall questions.
So interesting. I've had a blast with you guys. I can't wait to stop by and see you when we're up that way.
Yeah, and when you get up to the Portland or even Northern Cali, we'll come and find you guys and hopefully introduce ourselves.
Absolutely.
Yeah, wonderful.
We're really excited about it. And like I said, we're excited about the project. And we play Fanny on our show. You know, we have for several years. And we're just big fans. We're really, really stoked about the new project. And we are definitely going to come out and catch you guys live. I cannot wait for that.
And we're going to play a song now from the Motivator album. As a matter of fact, we're going to play Get Together, I think.
Okay.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, we did the Motivator last week. So this week it's a Get Together. And is there anything we should know about it?
I love Get Together. Kirk Passage, our record company president, Blue Alon Records, suggested that we do that song, and the minute he said it, it's like, who doesn't love Get Together and love one another right now, especially in these times?
In these
it's
times,
a wonderful
especially.
Song, and I'm so glad that we did it, and yeah, I love the way it came out.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Bree, for taking the time to join me and Tracy on the show tonight, and we wish you nothing but the best in the future, and we'll definitely talk to you down the road.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, Bree. We appreciate it so much, and I look forward to meeting you in person.
Yes, can't wait to meet you.
Okay, have a great evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bree, and thank you to Ken Phillips for organizing this, and thank you, the listeners, for listening to this great chat with Bree. We are going to go ahead and roll into a tune from the upcoming Motivator album, which will hit stores August the 2nd. Make sure you find it on social media. Look for it in stores. Ask your friends until you get it in your hot little hands. Here we are at Cherie Carey with Bree Darling and Get Together at the Church of Rock and KSKQ Radio.